You don't believe how hot it is. It's this hot. Wow, shiny again. It's this hot. It's so friggin' hot in here. I do have my fan on, but it doesn't seem to be working.
Hi, I'm Tangles. This is my garage, and this is my car.
Good morning, YouTube and the internets. Today, I'm doing something different. Today, I'm going to show you what you should have, or what you need, for motorsports. I was watching someone's video the other day, and they forgot their chair. The chair is a very critical part of your motorsports travel kit, and it is in the pile of stuff behind me. But it got me thinking, well, what do you need to take for people who are new to motorsports? Not that I'm, you know, a 20-year veteran or anything, but I've quickly figured out what stuff I have to take and what stuff is nice to take if you've got the space. So behind me is a pile of junk that I'm about to run you through. The must-haves. You must have a reasonable toolkit, which includes multiple sockets, ratchets, a breaker bar. You must have a breaker bar. Some spanners, just a simple, decent toolkit. Doesn't have to be gold plated, doesn't have to be, 300 piece. It just needs to have some good stuff that you can get suspension components off, for example, or at very least bodywork panels, things like that. So, toolkit, it's nice. If you can get some ratcheting ring spanners, not required though, not necessary. That is an added extra. You must have a tray of some sort. This is a small magnetic tray. It fits very easily into my little kit. If you're at Queensland Raceway drifts on a Friday night, you cannot see your bolts if you drop them. Put them in a magnetic tray, you will not lose them. You must have a set of jumper leads for obvious reasons. You must have a selection of zip ties. I've got two bags of the same type there. I've got more around, I just haven't got them here. In the case of a turbo car, some spare silicon or silicones. That's just one for an example. Some RTV, same reasons. Some spare clamps, once again, for a turbo car. A selection of sizes for the silicon joiners, and to go with that, some hose clamps, some miscellaneous stuff. Two caps. Now these came with my intercooler when I bought them, and I've kept them because in the case of a rupture in the intercooler or something like that, I can use these to block the cooler piping. That way I can drive home with no burst. A helmet. Check your local regulations for what you require. Ours are very simple for most of the stuff we need. Now, paper towel. Trust me, you want it. The next thing on the must list, as we go left to right, is, well, it's not actually a must. It's a must for me, but it doesn't have to be a must for you. A rattle gun with a proper wheel bit, because these are aluminium, they don't damage the wheels as much when you're doing wheels as often as I do. It's important. A portable drill. There's no point having all your fully sick drift tires to do you, did I say that right? Fully sick zip tires to do your fully sick drift stitch if you can't put holes in anything. You'll need a drill. And some drill bits, also important. This is a very cheap set of drill bits that I don't mind damaging, breaking, losing. Has, I'll show you, lots and lots of different sizes in it. Okay. Next, if you're doing anything but drifting, and even drifting actually, because I do check my tire pressures for drifting, you want a tire pressure gauge. This is a non-requirement. This is a laser thermometer, infrared thermometer. I can't get it out with one hand. It is not necessary. However, it's pretty handy if you're doing time attack and things like that, so you know what temperatures your brakes and things are getting to. Again, if you've got an okay toolkit, you don't have to have this, but it's nice to have another set of spinners which go up to a bigger size, in this case 32. And it's always nice to have options, so you've got you know, you can have the same, a spanner on either end of something instead of having to have ratchets, but having ratchets is important as well. Some large sealable bags for putting shit in. You'd be surprised how much shit you collect at a racetrack. You need to put it somewhere. A funnel or two is a good idea, not absolutely necessary if you can pour straight. Some good blast tape. Some people call this gaffer tape, whatever, this is blast tape. Yeah, so some good strong blast tape. Some good duct tape. D-U-C-T. Some electrical tape. Different colours is always handy, but you don't have to. A portable light. A reasonable, reliable portable light source. It's not 100% necessary, but it is very nice. A headlamp light is a must. A couple of torches in case one is not working is a must. A pair of gloves for working on the car is a must. If you have a job that's a bit bigger or involves fluids, some nitrile rubber gloves like you will have in your garage. A selection of hammers, rubber mallet, another small soft mallet. Now normally I would have my 2 pound lump hammer and my 1 pound engineering hammer here, penning hammer. They're somewhere else. So the bidet would absolutely 100% be in this kit before those two hammers. Now, that kit over there doesn't have any screwdrivers in it. So some screwdrivers. If your kit has screwdrivers, you don't need to worry about it. A half round file and a round file for filing stuff. Not 100% required, but pretty handy in the case of repairs on the side of the track or in the pits. A magnetic tool for grabbing stuff. A claw tool for grabbing stuff. A long magnetic tool for grabbing stuff. When you drop shit in the pits, it's not pleasant. Some side cutters, some pointy nose pliers, some pliers, vice grips, inspection mirrors. So you can see behind shit, especially when it's hot. These are just an assortment of bits that go in this screwdriver, and this is a 5-to-1 ratio geared head on it, so that's always handy. Some line clamps just in case. A Stanley knife with spare blades. I did this so they're easier to find in the box. Nikos pens. Whenever you go to motorsports, you almost invariably have to fill out a form or sign something. Take them with you. Vice grips are a must. You do not have 7 hands in a full workshop. Some Allen keys, vice grips, industrial type scissors, pointy nose pliers. A couple of pry bars. I've only got the little one here. The bigger ones are with my hammers, which aren't here. A saw blade. To cut down on size, I don't take a full hacksaw. I do take this. Now, there are the little half-size ones. I'd recommend getting one of those. A shifter. Always handy just to have one. You never know. In the it's nice too, but not necessary pile. I've forgotten what it's called now. what are they called? Multimeter. A multimeter. Right. Also, a tub. You want a good quality solid plastic tub to put all the shit in. Other things you will take, or that I will take, a spare set of spark plugs. When I changed the plugs last time, I kept the old ones, they're fine. They will get me home. They will get me a few more laps. They will work just fine until I get the car home, just in case something happens. This is my miscellaneous tub of bolts, screws, washers, just stuff. You never know when you're going to need it. Bit of hardware, something's broken, something's lost, you've dropped it, you can't find it, there's a replacement in there. When you're going to do time attack or hell climb or whatever, you don't want to turn up with the tires that you've got and nothing else. If you get a flat, your day's ruined. Take a spare pair at least, so you can put them on the front or the rear and at least keep going for the day. Ideally a whole set. Now, and ideally I would probably like to take these with the semi-slicks that are over there as wet tires to an event, if it's a weekend long event, This is all assuming you got space. I haven't had a problem with space for the big events I go away. I've hired a trailer, so I've been able to load the car on the trailer and have plenty of space in the Falcon to get everything I needed. You will need a floor jack, trolley jack, whatever you want to call it. You'll need a decent one so you can pick the car up. On that, you'll need axle stands, which all four of mine are under the car, and all four of them come with me to every event. Depending on where you are and what type of fuel you run, you will probably want some fuel in a jerry can. You will want some spare oil. My case, that for the Skyline. Nice to have, but not necessarily some spare coolant. Absolute must is some water. This is demineralized water. That, as long as you got that, you don't necessarily have to have this. And I usually have a thing of tap water with me as well. Just as much for the tow car as the race car. Just for an emergency, just to be able to get shit done. You know, if you have to put tap water in your cooling system, just flush it afterwards and it should be okay. Some brake fluid. If you start dropping brake fluid, you want to be able to stop later. Or if you get air in your system, just, you know, if something goes wrong. You don't need any of this if everything goes perfectly all weekend. But if everything goes perfectly all weekend, well, it wouldn't be motorsport. I stated before, a chair. A camping chair. Comfortable, fold-out chair. If you don't have that, your weekend is ruined. It is dead set, game over. It's not worth turning up. You might as well turn around and go home. A nice thing to have is a stubby cooler. Keep your drinks cold. You spend most of the time in the car. You're not going to spend most of it drinking your drinks. They're going to get warm. The other thing for your electrical devices is a portable charging device that's not reliant on anything else. So this is battery operated. This will keep your phone going, charge your camera slightly depending on what it is. But yeah, these days they've got those, this is about 7 or 8 years old. These days they've got those good portable battery pack things with multiple cords on them. They're a good thing, you should have one of those. A little cooler bag once again, keep drinks cool. Keep everything cool all day. It's not going to be perfect, but it's better than nothing. In the nice to have category is a marquee tent gazebo type thing. Here comes a wanker. If you're going to an event like Mount Cotton Hill Climb, your car's left there overnight, exposed. Similarly, Noosa Hill Climb, you're going to want one of these to put over your car. It's also nice while you're there to have shaded area. And to go with that, though you can't see it here, but if you watch my Noosa Hill Climb, you'll see this on the ground under the car. I think in the thumbnail shot, I've got a thing down. This is not a normal tarp, this is an advertising billboard thing material. It's very heavy duty. It's also a pretty good to have thing. So when you're at your hill climbs away under that thing, you don't have to work on the ground, in the dirt, in the mud, if it rains, you've got something a little bit clean to work on, and something you can move the car off it and sweep the junk away, get back on it. You'll see any oil drips with the white side up. It's a handy thing to have. I think those are the most important things. Oh, rags. You're going to want some rags. A couple of dirty rags, a couple of clean rags. Once again, I have more rags than that. I normally take more. That's just to show you and so I don't forget on the video. Yeah, that's about it. Obviously, anything else you're going to want, you better take. So, I hope that's been helpful for anyone first starting out in motorsports. You'll figure out which items within that list are the number one priorities for you and the number two priorities. Number one priority is the chair, the tub, the helmet, then those spare parts like silicons, fluids, things like that. Think anything that's going to stop your weekend if you don't have it is a priority one. Anything that's going to make your weekend more comfortable while you're there and easier and less stressful, because motorsports can be stressful when you elbows deep in your engine bay after 3 runs and some dude's just beating your lap time and you should be faster than him and the car's broken and you're yelling and screaming at shit, it gets stressful. So you want the shit there to be able to make it less stressful, so the right tools to fix the job if you can. and also something to make yourself comfortable while you're waiting for the next run, so you can go back out there and spank old mate who just beat you because you were busy fixing your car. Also, a race car. Race car is also a very good idea. So if you can think of anything that I didn't list, feel free to let me know in the comments below. Also, I know it seems cheesy, but everyone seems to do it. Be sure to click the subscribe button just somewhere on the screen, and the little bell thing, because the notification problems that YouTube have. And let your mates know. If they're into cars, maybe they want to watch it. Probably not, but can't hurt to ask.